I think one way to think of this is part of the first time when we meet a patient and we make a diagnosis, we are trying to understand how extensive is the injury to the body from vasculitis. In fact, for many of our vasculitis diseases, we borrow terminology from our cancer colleagues like staging, and we talk about different phases of treatment like induction and remission maintenance. This does not mean when we use these words that a vasculitis patient has cancer. But what it does mean is that just like cancer, vasculitis can be widely active throughout the body, or it can be focused on specific areas of the body. And so based on that, we would decide what is the intensity and duration of treatment that we need to use. So when we talk about rheumatic disease treatment in general, we talk about different categories of drugs. There are, first off, fast-acting and slow-acting medications. And unfortunately, really the fastest thing that we have being able to get some sort of symptomatic relief and some biologic effect within a matter of hours to days, the only thing we have in that category is steroids. But as many of our patients know, the side effects of steroids long-term are often much worse than many of the, almost all of the other rheumatic drugs that we use to treat rheumatic disease in general, not just vasculitis. And so for most patients, almost all patients with vasculitis, we end up using other, what we call steroid-sparing or non-steroid immunosuppressive drugs to shut down or reprogram the immune system. And then also there is a chemotherapeutic agent which is used for severe forms of vasculitis called Cytoxan. But these are high-intensity immunosuppressive agents. So one of the things to remember with vasculitis being injury to blood vessels, part of the healing of blood vessels really is increasing blood flow. It really comes down to all the more for purposes of healing and also just for long-term lifestyle and healthiness, really being vigilant about a good cardiovascular regimen, both in terms of diet and exercise. For patients with, for example, giant cell arteritis or Takayasu arteritis, the vasculitis diseases which can attack the heart and the large vessels, maintaining the overall health of those blood vessels is key to preventing future complications. We also know that atherosclerotic disease or cholesterol and hypertensive vessel disease from aging and lifestyle, that patients with vasculitis, and because of the prior injury from previous flares, sometimes can have a harder time recovering from things like heart attack and stroke. And so for that reason, we really emphasize that patients who have had a history of vasculitis be vigilant about maintaining a balanced, healthy diet and exercising regularly. So when you come to us and we establish a diagnosis and we start treatment, while you may not feel well, part of how well and how quickly you recover long-term is really a function of how soon can you start getting back to regular physical activity, even if that's just walking for 5 minutes a day. Again, it really is a matter of increasing blood flow, that there is something about this process which enters into a positive feedback cycle, where it really can and does make a difference in how quickly and how well you recover long-term from previous autoimmune injury.